Hello everybody, my name is Pravus and welcome back to more Hearts of Iron 4 Battle for the Bosporus, playing as the Ottoman Sultanate, which, you know, awesome, it's not quite an empire, but we're working on that part. I am currently trying to get some claims on Greece, and if we can quickly knock down Greece, that would certainly be very helpful to the expansion of the Turkish Empire. One major problem I'm running into, though, of course, is that World War II has begun, and the Germans did manage to get Bulgaria to join the Axis, so my options as far as actually getting Bulgaria to align with me and subjugate is pretty nil. There's not a whole lot of options to go around there, unfortunately. One thing I'm concerned about is if we don't go fast enough on Greece, Italy might attack Greece, and if that happens, then that means Greece is going to join the Allies, which means if I'm fighting Greece, I'll be fighting the Allies, which means I have to join the Axis, which kind of means I'm screwed. So this run may already be doomed, and I'm only just now figuring some of that out, in which case I'll restart and play up roughly to this point, and we'll do an ahistorical run and see if that will be any better. But I don't know. Maybe it'll be great, maybe it won't. I need to save up some political power, because a goal, of course, of once we get to Greece will be to change up some conscription law, because I'm kind of low on manpower, and that's not really acceptable to me. We need to get a lot more out there if we want to be a competitive force. Also, I would love to change up to war economy if that were possible, but, you know, we'll see. Conscription law more important right now. Desperately need to get some of that manpower up and a running. Also, desperately need to get some planes going, too, if possible. I did, swap one of my dockyards over to producing a sub. I don't know if we're gonna get this before the war goes. Probably not. But on the off chance we're finding ourselves stymied, one extra sub makes a difference. I don't know. What I'm really concerned about is not being able to land my troops, because we can't get the 50% naval supremacy that we need. That could very easily happen. I'll need to make sure I have my ships and my planes ready to go just in case, but yeah. I don't know. What are you gonna do, right? It is what it is. Okay, so let's make sure we get at least a couple of infantry over here, because I do want to make sure we can quickly grab these islands and knock Greece out here. We are going to have a little bit of trouble around Alexandropolis, because there is a fort, and there is a river crossing that we're going to have to worry about. How big is your fort? Level 2. Level 2 fort, it's not outrageous, but it will be difficult. This is going to be a huge bottleneck for me. I have an idea on how we can manipulate the Greek AI to make this a lot easier for me to finish off, but a lot of it will depend on my ability to follow through and quickly knock them down. I did change up one of the naval invasion ports to not go directly for this port down here, because I'd rather make sure we stick all to one sea zone so I can possibly land all of them quickly. That is the hope. We're also training a little bit to just try and get rid of some of the green troops. Because, I mean, why have green troops, right? We got 1 month before I can technically go to war. 1 month. That is not a lot of time, is it? Am I currently consuming any fuel? I shouldn't be. No, we're building up a stockpile. Good. If we run out of fuel, then I actually will be in a lot of trouble. Because I need planes, I need ships. So, don't want to run out of none of that, none. It would be a lot easier for me to take out Greece if I had spent the time working on building up a compliance government in Greece so that they would fall apart and capitulate really, really quickly. Instead, though, I spent a lot of time trying to help burn down some of the separatism amongst the Kurds. And you can see it is going down, but it got really bad for a while. And that's, of course, costing me a lot of manpower. That's costing me a lot of equipment. It's just not great. Just not great. The compliance is up to 32% now. I mean, whoop-de-frickin-do, right? We are using the local police forces, which helps. I wanted to use the reconciliation and stuff, and it does help a little, but like, eek. We've got to keep that sort of that rebellion down a bit. Otherwise, it's just going to continue becoming an issue. So I don't know. I'm doing all I know how to do at this point, all right? I just feel, I have this sneaking suspicion that this game has screwed me over because of the Bulgaria situation. And maybe because I didn't go quite fast enough in some stuff. Also, by the way, worth noting, down this tree, the only options we have are down here to finish up this tree with the Ottoman Empire. We can't do literally any of this, so that's a no. But we do have the ability to modernize our forces a little bit up over here, reforming our armed forces, modernizing our tactics, overhauling our training methods, blah, blah, blah. These are all things I would need to do in order to get rid of the disorganized armed forces. And don't forget, the disorganized armed forces is making me lose 8% division, 10% speed, fleet coordination, blah, blah. This is just terrible, you know? So we want to be able to get rid of that. We want to be able to get rid of that nice and quick, but oh well. So these guys should be done training. Let's go ahead and get rid of that. You guys are all green as well, so let's stop training with you. We don't need regulars. That'd be nice, but now we only have a few days left until I need to be able to declare war on Greece, and I'm going to want to have all of my organization ready to go. So here's what I'm thinking with Greece. Once we attack Greece, they're going to send almost everything they've got up here, which is what I want because that makes it easier for me to do a naval invasion more or less unopposed. Right? Right. But if there's a lot of troops here, I'm not going to be able to punch through this fort. So what I'm going to do, actually, is create a fallback line right along here. The goal will be to pull back just enough that they send their troops up along here. Then I punch through here and then sneak up to Alexandropolis while they have nothing defending and very low organization and encircle some units and see if that works against Greece. I think it will. It sounds bold, but I think it will work. We'll find out. Find out very soon, in fact. Still don't have enough political power for a manpower upgrade with the conscription law once the war begins. So that's going to be at least a little bit away still. But oh well. All right, so this will be done. Any second. There we go. All right, so Greece. You are actually independently guaranteed by Romania, but I honestly don't think Romania will do much. So I'm not really that worried about it. So we have a couple options now. We could go for the pressing of the Austro-Hungarian claims, which actually will give me claims on a lot of stuff, which is fun, but I'm not sure it's going to do me a lot of good. When unaligned support is high enough, enables decisions for these nations to reform the Austro-Hungarian Empire and join the Central Powers. Could we possibly get Hungary to swap over to non-aligned? And join a faction? I mean, they're fascist, but they haven't joined the Axis yet. No, they're joining the Axis right now. Literally, right there. Yeah, never mind. Okay, so not a lot of point in hoping for that, and I'm not going to use claims right now. I think I'd rather go ahead and learn our mistakes from the Great War. So we are no longer the old man of Europe, and that will have to be good enough. All right. Planes, where are you? You guys, get over here. Yep, I know what I'm doing. Go over here. And all of you are actually not going to be doing close air support, but you are going to be doing naval strike in the ocean. Let's go ahead and abandon the army for a moment. That'll be fine. So we're going to try to get some air superiority. Maybe we can bomb a few ships from here. With my navy, you guys are doing nothing right now, but I'm going to somehow hope that I can get enough for a naval invasion. We could try for a naval invasion immediately. My concern is instead of going to the north, he's going to flood everything he's got down to the south. At which point I'm in trouble. How am I going to do this? There's no point in having these guys operate until I'm ready to do the naval invasion. So let's save the fuel. Let's not worry about these guys right now. So do we declare war on you right now? I think the answer is yes. All right, so we're at war with the Greeks. We could attack. I don't see the point. I'd rather start pushing in here. There's some weak cavalry over here, which doesn't bother me too much. Let's just go ahead and attack them. I'll go ahead and use these guys to help reinforce a little bit, just so we can pin them down and beat them a little bit faster. If we can just kill these guys real quick, that frees up a couple troops. I could attack this right now, but I guarantee you he's going to flood everything he's got right here. So this is a trick. I don't want to go there. I'm going to let him come to me. We're not going to attack here yet. And then I'm going to strategically back off and see if we can get the surrounded encirclement. I think that's going to just absolutely obliterate him. I think. I've done this sort of thing before against the AI before, and it usually works really well. The right strategic redeployment and retreat is amazing. All right, now he's starting to bring some troops in. How many do we think you have? Anywhere between 6 and 29. You've probably got at least like 15, maybe 20. Different soldiers. We're about to kill one of them, so that's fun. But yeah. Okay, so that's done. These guys can all go back up here. I'm gonna wait until he sends them up here. I'm hoping he's gonna send, like, 10. There's 6. Italian-Bulgarian military technology exchange. There's 8. Okay, and we're sending the rest of our attack troops with some artillery. We do have some of those, which is great. We got a few more options as far as what we can do for our country. Honestly, I don't think any of these are worth pursuing right now. I'm just going to save the political power for the conscription law. Since we actually did throw away a little bit of manpower. There's 9. There's 10. Okay. So with all of you, we're going to back off. Just retreat, and let's see if it works. I think because Adern is a victory point, he's going to feel inclined to jump over here. And this way we can fight him without having to cross a river. So as soon as we're out of here, I think he's going to move. There's 12 now. There it is! That's what I was talking about. Improved computing machine. Okay. Let's see. Now we have 1940. I would probably want to go for the soft attack on my infantry. So he needs him to spread out. I also need this to be his weak point, if possible. We'll need to be careful about how I pin him down. I want him to treat like this. That's actually good. It actually would be to my advantage to pin you down exactly where you are right there. Using my infantry, he's going to send a fair bit up here, in which case I then sneak over here and grab Alexandropolis. But I need to lose this fight. I don't want to win it. I don't want to lose too many troops either. I literally just need to pin him down and keep him under control. So try for this. I'm going to let you leave. I need my offensive units all right here. Nope, 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 no. I already messed it up. Get down here, this way. I don't want to contest him right here. This is fine. Okay, that's it, right there. Hang on. If you're actually going to be that stinking stupid, then I will absolutely take advantage of this. He's left himself completely vulnerable with 12 troops. That's going even better than I could possibly have hoped. So I need a few of you, actually, to also go over here so we can reinforce this area. He's going to have no reinforce. He just killed himself. He just killed himself like an idiot. All right. Well, with that done, let's go for the encirclement there, and we just have to hold that point. Now we're going to take you guys. I'm going to go for naval invasion support. And we're going to try to go for a naval invasion. It doesn't say we have what we need. Let's go for my planes. Air superiority, naval strike. It's not enough. We don't have enough invasion support. 45% out of 50. That's not what I wanted to see. Sometimes it gets a little weird if you just, like, patrol instead. Sometimes you get better naval invasion. Like, we have to win some fights here. And try to destroy him. Like, that's really what we gotta do, is try to catch him and... No, don't strike force. Hang on. We've got to try to actually intercept him. Locating right now. He's locating the task force. If we can destroy a few of his ships and make him retreat, that would be all I need. All right, that right there is an encirclement. I'm going to send some of you guys now to run this way, preferably before he can train up any new troops quickly. Try to get through this bottleneck, if possible. And you guys... are just gonna stay here now and keep him encircled and don't let him leave. And we're gonna let him starve himself out. I'm not looking to do much. I just wanna keep his organization low. He shouldn't be able to get much from his attrition. I don't wanna waste a lot of material either. Okay, hang on, he's already sending some reinforcements. What I need to do is send my offensive units here, beat them before they can get to too many more forts. I'll leave one here at least. We can beat him to the fort so he doesn't get the reinforcements, then fight him here. And if we just keep pushing, it'll be okay. I need to make sure that we actually do have that there. I want to make sure we get a planning bonus. He has some troops over here, but it won't be much. So now it comes down to if I can get the naval invasion, if I can get that to work, we'll be in really good shape. Still locating, trying to engage, force him to retreat. We are now engaged. Pilot promoted, okay, that's fun. So, if we can engage and beat him down quick, he's retreating. That might be enough to force him out. Could you please stop? Could you stop? Like, freaking knock it off. I know what's happening. I understand what's happening. Oh my god. I know. I don't care. Back off. Make him retreat. Okay. Fleet. Why are we still not in control? There we go. Okay. Now we're launching. He retreated. Now we're launching. If all of his troops are up here, we land down here, we can definitely get a foothold in southern Greece, grab Crete, try to make a run for Athens, and see if we can end this war fast. He's retreating up here, which means we're going to get this fort. That's good. These guys have no organization support, so they're going to fall apart. Let's Let's actually try to speed this up by attacking from a couple different directions and just try to take a little less losses if we can. I'm losing a lot of manpower in the process here, but I think it's well worth it in order to make sure we win this one quick. I need to get the engineer companies. We've been neglecting that so far. It's coming back with some more reinforcements. That's fine. Here we go. Here we go. If we can just land here without unopposed, we're going to be fine. What I can do is actually change you guys to now do naval invasion support. So they'll break off on this engagement once they win, which we're about to do, and then they'll go and assist in making sure we get a good landing. Okay, learning from the Great War, I think we go ahead and do... Or do we go for the claims? I'm not going to be able to fight Yugoslavia on my own, am I? If I had Bulgaria on my side, I think the answer would have been yes. But as is, I don't know about that. Modernizing the army gives me a chance to get my organization back, and we are going to need some of that. Now, Greece is likely going to rapidly redeploy a load of green troops. That's annoying, but fine if it does happen. Okay, we've landed. Good. Now you're going to head up here immediately. You're going to head up here immediately. You're going to try to get up to Corinthos. We've landed in Crete. Send one of you guys over here. I don't know if there's going to be anyone defending. There may or may not be. But we will see. I just realized that these are held by the UK. I think we need to own Rhodes at some point. I could be wrong, though. Okay, are we landing? Where are you guys? Why are you only over here? Hurry up! Okay, we're finishing these guys off nicely. You guys get over here. You assist. Get over here. We're gonna grab this fort. If I can then get down over... If I can get through the fort and then get down here, we can cut this guy off, maybe. Low organization, but not enough. He might retreat. He did retreat, actually. Okay, I think we just technically got another encirclement. Rebuilding our home is done. Oh, and I now can go for the conscription law. No, I can't. Oh, no! We're killing his troops too fast! No! No! Oh, that sucks! All right. Well, we might as well... And we killed his troops too fast. I should have kept him encircled. I didn't think about that. Crap. Alright, get up to Corinthos. I have to at least get some ports so that these guys don't die. We did finish this all off, so that's good. Let's get rid of this front line, assign all of you here. I meant to still have some of you guys push this way. Get up to Corinthos. One of you get up here to Patras, since he's left this completely unprotected. Move you guys up over here, then we're gonna go for an offensive line. I needed that conscription. Oh, crap, I screwed up so bad. Grab Thessaloniki real quick. That's a good port. These guys are going to die. This will be a good defensive spot for me. Okay, all of these guys can now join up on the front line. We've got Greece. We got him. Ladies and gentlemen, we got him. But I'm out of manpower because I screwed up and I shouldn't have killed him as effectively as I did. I should have been more lenient and less murdery. Alright, well, fleet, you can go on a hold mode. You guys actually don't need to be here anymore. We're gonna turn off the naval strike, go ground support, and let you just assist in Greece. A little bit of extra air support will help. Not much, though, but a little bit. Yeah, I see we're not winning this fight, but it doesn't matter. Alright, he actually has left Athens completely open. We're gonna take it. We're gonna be able to capitulate this guy quick. We need to keep pushing the advantage and not stop, though. We cannot stop. Because if he starts rapidly redeploying some new troops, I'm actually going to run into a bit of a headwind. Okay, now we have a port. We actually have two. I think Corinthos has one as well. There's Petrus, at least, so that's done. Let's get over here. You need to actually just keep him pinned down. Don't let him join in on a thing. We've got Athens. This guy has nowhere to go, so he's actually going to die. Got that. Go grab these islands real quick. We are bringing in reinforcements. We have more factories. Logistically, what do we want? We're out of fighters and stuff, but everything else is more or less okay. I don't need transport planes. I think we should go ahead and start producing some motorized. We aren't going to use it right away, but at least having some being produced makes sense. And I do want to trade for a little bit more aluminum, as well as some rubber. Let's say from Brazil. I don't know. I don't really care. It's fine. Do that. There you go. Here come reinforcements. No, 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 no. Don't you do that. Don't you try to sink me with your subs. I'm going to do convoy escort with the fleet, and we're going to intercept them. There goes Greece. All right. Well, we got that. That's something. Take all states. End turn. Done. Problem is, we have no manpower to work with as far as controlling the population now. Because I really, 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 really needed conscription law. I almost am tempted to say we need to get claims against Yugoslavia just so we can be at war with someone who has enough troops that I can get conscription law. And then we just hold this front. Feels really crazy, doesn't it? But, I mean, it might be true. Well, at the very least, we managed to accomplish this goal. That's something. I'll take that. That was executed well. It was executed well. It was executed so well that I didn't think about the consequences of my actions. When will I learn that my actions have consequences? Never. I shall never learn. All right. Yugoslavia, the problem with them, they're going to be dang difficult to move through when they have so many mountains. Resistance is still ticking down over here. In my occupied territories here in Greece, we have to go for local police force. I need to make sure that we understand that garrisons do get priority, and I think that we've done that. So we actually have most of the manpower we need. We're still sort of okay. Romania. Annexed by Romania, stands significantly weakened. So it looks like Romania just lost some land. They just gave up stuff to Hungary, I think. It said Bulgaria, but I don't see any evidence they gave anything up to Bulgaria. It's a little weird, right? Why am I sending these troops down here? I mean, I think theoretically I could fight Vichy France at some point. The only way I would do so, though, is actually to join the Axis. Because their independence may be guaranteed by the Germans, but if I were in the Axis and I attacked Vichy France, who is not a part of a faction, technically speaking, I'd be able to grab Vichy France. I don't know. Joining the Axis might be an option. It doesn't feel like a very good option, but it is an option. You know what I could do with these guys is actually go for another naval invasion. From here to what? I would need ports. And then maybe we can take these guys and do something as well. I have a sneaky feeling that this would not work. And Yugoslavia will be defending their ports from a naval invasion, but I don't know. If we can draw enough of their attention up over here, maybe it would work. Until I get more manpower, though, what am I going to do? I don't know. I've screwed myself. I've screwed myself horribly. That's ironic. It really is. Bessarabia. Yeah, Romania is losing everything at this point. They lose a state in Bessarabia. They've lost Transylvania over to Hungary. Because Hungary joined the Axis. So, I mean, what's Romania going to do? Although it sure as heck looks like with inviting German advisors, these guys are going to be joining the Axis soon. I'm surprised that Yugoslavia has not joined anything. They're not even being guaranteed by anybody. So that's odd. Modernizing the army is done. So I do think that we need to go for this. The pressing of the claims. Let's take a look at what our reformation options are for our military. There it is. Modernizing the forces. We can increase our organization so we get rid of the 8% penalty for 50 political power. That's pretty good. Expand the air bases for division speed could be helpful. Training methods? Maybe. Yeah, that's all okay. Not great, but okay. We're trying to build up some compliance desperately here in Greece. Not getting very far. Getting some extra factories and stuff would be nice when we reorganize the workforce. We are getting 4,000 manpower out of Kurdistan right now, and I'm using up 5,000. So it's not yet reaching a point where we're getting enough manpower out of this to be worth it. What I could do is pull my spy off of this and just go and try to put down the rebellion chance here in Greece. What I really need to do is get up to local police force to reduce my required garrisons by a huge amount. The more the rebellion kind of goes up here, the resistance goes up in Greece, the more I'm going to have to spend on this. We don't have enough spies to go around with this. Can I possibly reduce this substantially? I don't know what your target is. Can I go ahead and start doing anti-partisan? Let's go ahead and improve the efficiency. I'll use up some factories, and I hate to do it, but we're going to. Because I need to be more efficient at getting rid of this nonsense. I would like to get some more military factories. Build a few over here. If I built one infrastructure level, I think that actually pays for itself. And then we go for this. There we go. Still want to get one there as well, and one here. Gosh dang it, Kurds. If only there was a way I could get you guys to really just leave me the freak alone. Seriously, the Kurds are killing me. Hey, reform the Ottoman Empire is an option here. Reform the islet of Rumela. We have to own Serbia, Macedonia, Bulgaria, Albania, Epirus. Oh my god, that's not happening. Not if we don't want to fight Italy and Bulgaria. And if we can own the islands that the UK is holding on to, I could get some cores out of this.
Oh.
Okay. So now I'm actually thinking that joining the Axis is a good thing. Maybe. Hmm. What is this with command power here? You seeing that? Separatist fatigue. Resistance decay speed goes up. Compliance growth speed. The separatists are getting fatigued? That's a good thing for me. Oh boy, I don't know. I don't know. I am struggling to see how we're going to recover from this. We desperately need to get manpower. Populism would help, but it's not enough. I need to go to war against Yugoslavia, basically. I think we have no choice. My question is, if we do that, does Yugoslavia join the Allies or the Axis? If they join either one of those, I'm stuck. And I have to join the other faction and pray that I can live. I think I need to join the Axis. Call me crazy, but I think we need to do that. Bulgaria's rebuilding their army. Yeah. What's going on up here in, like, the UK? Nothing. It's very quiet in the European front. It looks like they're going for Norway, and I think the Germans will be able to win that. They usually do. After that, then what does the German Reich do? Probably nothing. Gosh dang it, I cannot believe I was too effective. That's ridiculous. It hurts, man. You hate to see it. Absolutely hate to see it. We could start laying a bunch of mines. I don't think we have the tech for that. No, we have to be at war to do mine laying. We can get up here toward, like, convoy escort and stuff, but I would be doing naval invasion support right over here by Corfu. That is one way we could possibly beat the Yugoslavians. I mean, if we could beat the Yugoslavia, like, I'll feel a lot better about my situation. What we need is to be able to reform the Ottoman Empire and actually start getting cores, because cores are worth plenty more manpower. Way more. If I could get this, this would be amazing. Core all the Greek states? Like, yeah. But I can't do anything against Bulgaria, and I can't do anything about Albania. So, how does that help me exactly? And the answer is, at least right now, it doesn't. It doesn't help me at all. You guys are going to be going up here. And you will be operating in the Western Balkans, of course. We are at least starting to produce some planes. So we'll start building up a little bit of an air force. And yeah, right now the only thing I can do is just build up political power with the intention of going to war specifically so I have a reason to get more conscription law. It's times like this where you really wish you were fascist or communist, right? You really wish you were. This would easily be worth a lot more. Like right now, 2.5% is worth 400,000 manpower. You double that, I'm looking at a lot more manpower. All right, well, at least anti-partisan got an upgrade. Let's go for another level of that. They're still going up, and the more it goes up, the more manpower I need to use to keep Greece under control, which is a problem, because I don't have a lot of manpower to do that with. Are you guys still going down? The good news is the Kurds are still going down. Thank God for that. Leon Trotsky got assassinated. Okay. Compliance is going up. So Kurdistan is improving, and we're taking up less and less manpower as we go. But if I can't get enough manpower to keep Greece under control, that means that the resistance keeps spiraling up. Which means I need more garrisons, which I can't fulfill, which means it keeps going up. This is a feedback loop that will kill me. This is a feedback loop that will cost me the game if I don't get manpower. Okay. Well, I think I'm resolved in my path forward. My only path forward is Yugoslavia. We could also try to, you know, like, start fabricating claims against, like, let's say, Iraq and Iran with the intention of trying to get these guys to join my empire. I need to fight the I think I need to join the Axis. I benefit a lot from fighting the Allies. If I could somehow manage to take on Greece and trick the Germans into helping me fight Vichy France, I'd be in a pretty good spot. I also think we would benefit a lot from military police right now in order to save manpower with garrisons, since that's kind of killing me right now. So I'm going to go ahead and do this to increase my resistance so I need less garrisons so I'm actually able to survive this. All right, we're going to end this video here. War went well, but I doomed myself in the process. Thank you all for watching. Be sure to hit that like button, leave a comment, and subscribe. Hit that notify bell, and I will see you guys next time.
All right, let's go ahead and do it.